Hello friends, welcome back. In previous video, we had seen reciprocating air compressors. In this video, we are going to study centrifugal compressor, which is a type of rotary compressor. So, what are rotary compressors? Let us know first. It consists of rotor and casing arrangement in place of piston and cylinder arrangement. They are compact, well balanced and high in speed. They provide pulsation free air. They are used to handle large mass of air with low or medium pressure range. So before moving on to the explanation, let us see the difference between reciprocating air compressor and rotary air compressor. So first important point is the pressure ratio. So pressure ratio is higher in case of reciprocating compressor. It ranges from about 4 to 7, and in case of rotary compressor, it is low. It ranges from 3 to 5. The second parameter to be seen is the flow of air, the flow of delivery air. So it is intermittent flow in case of reciprocating compressor and continuous flow in case of rotary compressors. About size, size is higher, or you can say bulky, for reciprocating compressor because it consists of piston and cylinder arrangement. But in case of rotary compressors, rotor and stator, hence it is compact in size. And you can say quality of air in piston and cylinder arrangement, the lubricants are mixed in the cylinder. So quality of air is low, or you can say less pure air is obtained from reciprocating compressors. But in case of rotary compressor, there isn't mixing of any lubricants, hence you can obtain a pure, without any dirt in the delivery air. Next point, speed. Speed of reciprocating compressor is lower and speed of rotary compressor is higher due to rotary parts. Maintenance. Higher maintenance is required in reciprocating compressor due to more sliding parts, and lower maintenance required in rotary compressor due to less sliding parts. So you can say balanced rotary parts. Mechanical efficiency. It is lower in case of reciprocating compressor, again due to sliding parts, more wear and tear. And in case of rotary compressors, the mechanical efficiency is higher. So these are few important points which we can list down. There are many more points, but let us proceed forward for types of rotary compressors. So types are root blower, vane type, screw type, reciprocating type and axial type. So in this video, we are going to study centrifugal type compressor. They meet high demand of compressed air. They are used in oil refineries, gas turbines, in automobile for turbocharger, supercharger. They are even used in refrigeration, air conditioning and HVAC for various manufacturing processes. And as they provide oil-free compressed air, they are even used in food and beverage industry. So let us move to construction and working of centrifugal compressor. So this diagram is the sectional view. In this you can see the basic parts are impeller, diffuser and casing. So impeller consists of impeller blades which rotate inside the casing. The center of impeller is known as eye, which is connected to the drive shaft. The working is, as the impeller rotates, the air enters the impeller eye radially with low velocity and atmospheric pressure. Due to centrifugal action of impeller, air comes out radially in the impeller. Now the high speed of impeller results into a rise in momentum of air, which causes higher static pressure rise, temperature rise and also rise in kinetic energy. Now when the air leaves the impeller, it enters into the diffuser, where kinetic energy is converted into pressure energy and the static pressure of air increases further. So this air is then collected in the casing and delivered from the compressor with high pressure, high temperature and higher velocity. Moving on to velocity diagram at inlet and outlet of impeller blade. We can see the blades are designed in such a way that air enters and leaves the impeller blade without shock. So this is the triangle for inlet and this is the outlet triangle. So using the usual notations, we can see U1 is the blade inlet velocity, VR1 is relative velocity, V1 is the absolute velocity, VF1 is the flow velocity, angle alpha is air inlet angle, angle beta is blade angle. And the corresponding values of outlet are U2, VR2, V2, VF2, angle theta and phi. So we can say work input per kg of air W is equal to U1 VW1 plus U2 VW2, where VW1 and VW2 are whirl velocities at inlet and outlet. But as we know, air enters radially, hence alpha is equal to 90 degrees. Thus, we can say VW1 is equal to 0. So, substituting value of VW1 is equal to 0 in this equation, we obtain W is equal to U2 VW2 joules per kg. Also, we can say one more formula, CPT1 into P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma minus 1. So, power input is P is equal to M dot U2 VW2, where M dot is mass flow rate in kg per second. So these two formulas are really very important while solving the problems on velocity triangles. Next, let us see how to draw a combined velocity diagram for inlet and exit of impeller blades. So we have stepwise procedure. Point number one, draw a vertical line AB to represent flow velocity VF1. Now remember, flow velocity is equal at inlet as well as for exit. So draw a vertical line, name it as AB. So right now we don't know the value of VF1. So let us proceed on to next point. Horizontal line CA represents blade velocity U1 at inlet. So U1 can be found out from the formula U1 is equal to pi D1 N upon 60. So whatever value you are getting from this formula, you can convert it into scale and we can draw a horizontal line CA, where line CA is the value of U1. Now, next point. Line CB inclined at blade angle beta, which represents relative velocity at inlet. So from point C, we'll draw a line which inclines at angle beta. So the angle of inclination CACB is equal to beta. So the point of intersection obtained is the point B. Now let us move ahead. So this, first of all, the value of AB is equal to VF1, which is equal to V1. CB is the relative velocity VR1. And the angle over here is alpha. Now we are done with inlet velocity triangle. Let's move on to outlet velocity triangle. We know that flow velocity of inlet triangle is equal to flow velocity at the outlet. So we can say AB is common for both the triangles, inlet as well as outlet. So VF1 is equal to V1, which is equal to VF2. Now moving on to next point, line DB inclined at blade angle phi representing relative velocity VR2. So mark a point between CA such that the point is D and DB makes an angle of phi. So there are two methods to solve this. First one, we know alternate angles, if this angle is equal to phi, even its alternate angle will also be equal to phi. So from point B, we can mark point D such a way that the angle is equal to phi. So angle ADB will be also equal to phi. Or the second method we also know, in a right angle triangle, addition of the angles opposite to right angle is always 90 degrees. So angle ADB plus angle DBA is equal to 90. So this angle, whichever you are obtaining, so it will be 90 minus 5. So the value of DB is VR2, relative velocity at outlet. Now next point, line DE represents blade velocity U2. So blade velocity U2, you can find out by the formula U2 is equal to pi D2 N upon 60. So from point D, we can draw a horizontal line which represents the value of U2. So this point is represented by E. So DE is U2. And the last one, join line EB which represents absolute velocity VR2, which is inclined at angle theta. So we already have point E and point B, just join these two lines. So angle AEB will be angle theta. So this is the outlet velocity triangle. Now we know one thing, world velocity at inlet BW1 was equal to 0 and world velocity at outlet is from point A to point E. So value of VW2 can be obtained from this velocity triangle. So this velocity triangle is really important for solving the problems. Even if in problems it is not asked specifically, you can also solve with trigonometry, but solving with this method is really very beneficial. Now let us discuss few problems. Problem number 1. In a centrifugal compressor, the atmospheric air enters at 28 degrees Celsius and leaves at 110 degrees Celsius and 2 bar. Calculate the isentropic efficiency and power required by the compressor if 40 kg of air is compressed per minute. Take Cp equal to 1.00 kilojoule per kg Kelvin and Cv equal to 0.716 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. What is given in this problem? So atmospheric pressure P1 is given as 1 bar. Inlet temperature T1 is 28 degrees Celsius, converting it into Kelvins. Outlet pressure P2 is given as 2 bar and outlet temperature T2 is given as 110 degrees Celsius, converting that into Kelvin. Mass flow rate is given as 40 kg per minute. We have to convert that into kg per seconds. Cp and Cv, both the values are given in the problem. And they've asked to find isentropic efficiency and power input to the compressor. Let us see how to solve this problem. So index for polytropic compression gamma is given by Cp by Cv, which is equal to 1.4. This value remains constant for any isentropic compression. The term to be found out is isentropic efficiency. We know the formula T2S minus T1 upon T2 minus T1. We have the value of T1 and T2, but we do not have the value of T2S. So first let us find out the value of T2S by the formula T1 into P2 by P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So substituting all the values, we obtain the answer as 366.9 Kelvin. So substituting this value of T2S in this equation of isentropic efficiency, we are obtaining the answer as 0.8037. So always efficiency is measured in percentage. So it is 80.37%. Next term to be found out is power input for compression. So we know the formula for power input mCp delta T, where m is mass flow rate in kg per seconds. So substituting all the values, we are obtaining the answer as 54.94 kilowatts. So both the answers are found out. Next problem. A rotary compressor handles 3 kg of air per second running at 2400 rpm. The internal and external diameters of impeller are 120 mm and 240 mm respectively. The impeller angle at the exit is 35 degree. The air enters impeller radially with 7 meters per second. Calculate the vane angle at inlet. Also calculate the power required to drive the compressor. Scene given. Mass flow rate is given 3 kg per second, RPM is given, inner diameter and outer diameter is given, angle phi is given as 35 and velocity is given as 7 meter per second. It is asked to find out vane angle at inlet, so that is beta, and power required. So first of all, before solving this problem, let us know what kind of problem is this, whether velocity triangle is required or not. So what is our power required? We know the formula for power required as m dot w, where w is work input, which has the formula u2 vw2. So this term vw2 will be obtained only from the velocity triangle, as well as the blade angle beta is also obtained from the velocity triangle. So it is confirmed that this problem is a type of velocity triangle. Now let us see how to solve this problem. So first step is to find out the linear velocity of impeller at inlet as well as outlet. So inlet u1, we know the formula pi d1 n upon 60, and at outlet is pi d2 n upon 60. So substituting all the values, we are getting the answer as u1 is equal to 15.01 meter per second and u2 is equal to 30.12 meter per second. So now let us start drawing the velocity triangle. So first step was to draw a vertical line with flow velocity as AB. But right now in this problem, velocity V1 is given as 7 meter per second. So converting it into suitable scale, draw a vertical line naming it as AB. So where velocity V1 is given as 7 meter per second. V1 is also equal to VF1. So first step is done. Next step is to construct a horizontal line representing velocity u1, inlet velocity, so naming it as point C. So line AC represents inlet velocity u1, which is equal to 15.01 meter per second. Now the last one is to join line CB. So angle ACB makes angle beta. So from this triangle, we can find out the value of beta, which is equal to 25. So our first answer is done. Second one is to construct the outlet velocity triangle. So one basic thing for centrifugal compressors is that inlet flow velocity is equal to outlet flow velocity. So VF1 is equal to VF2. Line AB is common for both the triangles. Next step is to mark a point D such that A angle ADB makes an angle of 35 degree, which is equal to 5. Now we have already studied two methods, either by alternate angles, so alternate angles are always equal 35, or addition of two angles is equal to 90 degree. So from any of these both methods, we can mark point D. Joining line DB will give you the angle 5, which is equal to 35. Next step, from point D, draw a line horizontal which represents outlet blade velocity u2. So from point D, draw a horizontal line, name the point as E. So DE is representing the velocity u2. So finally, join line DE, which represents the velocity v2. So angle DEB will be obtained, so which is equal to 5. So this is done with the velocity triangle. So now measure all the sides and convert back it into scale. So we'll be obtaining the values. So from the triangle, AE is the value of VW2, which we have obtained it as 20.7 meter per second. So now substituting this value of VW2, in the equation of work input, we are obtaining the answer as 623.484 joule per kg. And the last one, power input, is mass flow rate into work. So substituting both the values, we are obtaining the answer 1.87 kilowatts. So hence this is the problem. Next problem, a centrifugal compressor runs at 8000 rpm, handles 4.8 meter cube per second from 1 bar and 20 degrees Celsius to 63 degrees Celsius. The flow velocity is 65 meter per second, same at the inlet and outlet of compressor. The inlet and outlet impeller diameters are 320 mm and 620 mm respectively. Calculate number 1. Blade angle at inlet and outlet. Next one, absolute angle at tip of impeller. Number 3, width of blade at inlet and outlet. and last parameter degree of reaction. Now let us see given. Speed n is equal to 8000 rpm. Volume flow rate is given 4.8 meter cube per second. Initial temperature T1 is 20 degrees Celsius. Outlet temperature T2 is 63 degrees Celsius. Atmospheric pressure, that is P1, is equal to 1 bar. Volume flow rate at inlet and outlet is constant. Therefore, VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to 65 meter per second. Inlet diameters D1 is 320 mm, which is 0.32 meters. And outlet temperature D2 is 620 mm, which is equal to 0.62 meters. And it is asked to find, first one is angle beta and angle phi. The second term is angle theta. Third one, width at inlet and outlet, that is B1 and B2. And fourth one is degree of reaction. So to know what kind of problem is this, all angles are asked to find out. So definitely this is a velocity triangle type of problem. So let us continue finding U1 and U2. We know the formula, substituting all the values, we are getting U1 is equal to 134.04 meter per second and U2 we are getting 259.7 meter per second. So let us first start drawing the inlet velocity triangle. Draw a vertical line which represents flow velocity VF1. Now in the problem it is given VF1 is equal to VF2. So it is a vertical line, naming it as AB. Next step is to draw the horizontal line which represents blade inlet velocity U1. So line AC represents the value of U1. Now joining line C and B, we will be obtaining angle beta. Line CB represents relative velocity of inlet VR1. So from this diagram, we'll be obtaining the value of beta. Now to construct outlet velocity triangle. So for next step is to plot the point D. But to plot point D, neither we know any of the velocities nor we know the angle, because angle phi is to be found out. So how can we solve this? We can solve this by finding out the value of VW2, because already we know the value of U2. But no other values are given, hence we have to find out value of VW2. That can be found out with help of work input. So we know work input is equal to U2VW2 in kilojoule per kg, sorry, in joule per kg, which is also equal to Cp delta T. That is also in joule per kg. So substituting the value of U2, value of Cp as 1005, T2 and T1, we will obtain the value of VW2 as 166.4 meter per second. So when we obtain this value, we can complete the velocity triangle. So from point A, draw a line horizontal representing the value of VW2. Mark the point as E. When you have found the point E, draw a line horizontal, or you can say plot the point D such that line BE represents the velocity V2. So when we have found out the point D, join line DB. Line ADB represents the angle phi. Line DB is the value of VR2. So from this triangle we can find out value of phi, which is equal to 34. And the last one is join line BE, which represents velocity V2. Now angle AEB is the angle phi. So we have got all the three values of angle, that is beta, inlet and outlet blade angle, outlet is phi, and the value of theta. Also we have obtained the value of VR1 and VR2 by converting back into the scale. So for this problem I have considered scale as 25:1. Any scale can be considered according to the solver. Now next point to be found out is width of blade at inlet and outlet. So we know the formula for width of blade, B1, which is equal to volume flow rate divided by pi D1 VF1. So already the volume flow rate is given as 4.8. Substituting the other values, we are getting width of blade at inlet is 0.0 0735 meters, which is equal to 7.35 centimeter. And value of B2 is again same formula, volume flow rate divided by pi D2 VF2. So answer obtained is 3.8 centimeters. And the last point is degree of reaction. We know the formula for degree of reaction as 1 minus VW2 upon U2. So substituting all the values, we are getting answer as 0.6797. Every time remember, degree of reaction is measured in percentage. So we can write it as 67.97%. So guys, there is equal weightage for all steps in the problem. Maximum weightage is for velocity triangle. So do remember all the formulas and use it in the problem. Now let us discuss last point, choking and surging. So as you can see, I have drawn a characteristic curve of pressure ratio versus mass flow rate. Now consider the pressure ratio is reduced from point D. When pressure ratio reduces, the density of air, compressed air, also reduces at constant impeller speed. So when pressure ratio goes on reducing, the mass flow rate increases. As still ahead the pressure ratio is reduced, the slope of characteristic curves goes on reducing and it reaches point A where the mass flow rate cannot be extended from point A. So this phenomena is known as choking and point A is known as choking point. Next point, surging. Consider a compressor running at constant speed and full valve is open on delivery side. Now if a resistance is placed in between the delivery path, mass flow rate of the flow goes on reducing and the pressure ratio goes on increasing. So we can say the point shifts towards left. Still, if the resistance goes on increasing, mass flow rate will reduce and the point will reach in the zone DE. Now in zone DE, the downstream pressure is more than the actual delivery pressure, which results into reduction of pressure and the mass flow rate becomes zero, means fluid stops flowing. After some interval of time, the pressure inside the compressor builds up due to accumulation of mass from the compressor, which results into overcoming of the resistance and again the air flows freely. So this situation of instability in the compressor is known as surging. Hello guys, so this was an overview of centrifugal compressor. So I've tried to explain few concepts as well as few important problems which come under centrifugal compressor. Hope these are helpful for your studies.